Yo, what is up guys, Barbaric here, back with another video, and in today's video I will show you guys how to edit faster on Fortnite Mobile. But before today's video starts, I want to remind you, if you find this video informative at all, please drop a like. It really does help the video out a lot. And also all my socials and Discord and everything are in the description down below for you guys to know. Alright guys, first up we have our targeted edit button. Now for me personally, I do not use the drag edit where you use your finger and edit on the screen. I use this button where you hold it down, you have your cursor that's in the middle of the screen, and then you put it over the blocks that you guys want to edit. For me personally, this is a little bit better for mobile just because it takes time for you to move your finger to the middle of the screen to edit properly and then to move it back to the side of the screen where your buttons are. Instead, it's all in one place. And also with your crosshair, when you're editing, if a person is on the other side of the wall, maybe you can edit it and immediately have the crosshair on their head already and then shoot them in the face. And for me personally, that is the best editing to use for mobile. Now guys, for my element visibility for this button, I do have it on all of them, but it only shows up for build and edit, but that's all you need for it to basically show up for. But yeah guys, you don't need it in combat since you're not using that button to edit from the start. All right guys, the next button we have is edit toggle and reset. This is a button where you press and then you use the button we discussed over before to start the edits. So this button, you press it to start and then you use the other one, and then when you release, your edits are done. But what this button also does is it also resets. So you have it enabled in combat, build, and edit. So if you're in combat or anything, you need to reset an edit you just made. All you need to do is double click it and boom, it is reset. It is super fast for resetting and it is a must to have on your HUD. So you guys make sure you guys really need this button on your HUD. Now guys, for the last button that if you're trying to get better at your edits to enable is the confirm edit on release button. So for this button, once you release, then it just edits. Once you release your crosshair edit button, it automatically edits instead of pressing that edit toggle and reset button. So that is more for if you're trying to learn your edit and you want to learn new edits, definitely pick that button up. You guys definitely need this function. All right guys, now into going to how to learn how to edit and do the very sweaty edits to see Faze Sway and all these people doing. Now, if you're trying to practice some high grain retakes, all you really want to do is to go into creative for, I'd say, 10 minutes max and practice your edits, and this will just help you get better and better at your editing and muscle memory. And I still don't really know how to do it every single time, but I am getting there. So if you guys don't know how to do it, do not get discouraged. One day you guys will get how to do the edits and you'll be good. But not only that, creative is not where you guys want to stop. Once you have gotten enough confidence in creative to successfully do it at least once, then what you guys want to do is just go to random pubs, and when you just feel like it, run up to a random plane or anywhere you are on top of authority and just try the high ground retake and see if you can do it first try in a pub. Now what this does is you're in the mentality and mindset of a pub, so your edits will be different. Like for me, my edits in creative are much different than in pubs. In pubs, since I'm doing less edits overall, I tend to do them successfully more, so sometimes the high ground retakes will actually be easier in pubs, but at least for me. So it depends on the person doing them, and once you can do them successfully in pubs, you should be good to go and you'll have it in your muscle memory and then you can do it. Now the best way to learn these are doing them against actual players. So if you're against a person and he's on height and you're trying to learn the high ground retake, try to do the high ground retake against that person in the pub. And when you do it successfully, you will feel very accomplished, and that is very good for your mentality. Now guys, another edit I like to practice is when you're on the high ground and the person's building up, you place the floor cone and then immediately edit both, pump them in the face. And all I did to learn that one was go in pubs and try to edit as fast as I could. And now I can do it basically every time. And when I see a person coming up, I'll put it over their head. Both of them double edit and they will be dead, because most of the time they'll try to put a pyramid, and sometimes they think they put the pyramid, but really it's yours. And then you can capitalize off that and then pump them right in the face, guys. Now guys, that is basically all my advice I have for you guys. So go and do these steps and I guarantee your edits will become way better, like mine did, bro. I couldn't even do, okay, well, to be fair, I couldn't do, all right, the game ended, that's why. But yeah, I couldn't do a double edits and all this stuff. I did these steps and now I know how to do them every time. So guys, go out in Creative and Pubs and do these for yourselves. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Tell you what's on my mind. What's up? I've been calling you. It seems like I can't get to you. Thought I was good, yet I'm feeling.